Hello viewers and students, welcome once again to my channel Learn with me from home. This is Dr. Manpreet Kaur Plaha. In my last three videos I have discussed exhaustively about present, past and future tenses. Hope all the doubts are clear by now. Today we are going to do a comparative study of tenses only with examples. But before that, please subscribe, like and share my channel. Let's take up the comparative examples of simple present, past and future tenses. We see three columns and the first example coming up is of simple present tense. I write a letter, simple past tense. I wrote a letter, simple future tense. I shall write a letter. He eats an apple. He ate an apple. He will eat an apple. She sings melodiously. She sang melodiously. She will sing melodiously. They love to walk. They loved to walk. And they will love to walk. In these examples, you can see that all the principles used in present, past and future have been applied. The verb write in present tense is in the first form, in past it is in the second form, and in the future tense it is in the first form with shall or will. Next we come down to present continuous tense, past continuous tense and future continuous tense. And the first example coming up is of present continuous tense. I am writing a letter. I was writing a letter. I shall be writing a letter. He is eating an apple. He was eating an apple. He will be eating an apple. She is singing melodiously. She was singing melodiously. She will be singing melodiously. They are walking. They were walking. And they will be walking. We see the usage of the verb in ing form. With I we use am. In the past tense we use was plus verb plus ing. And in future continuous we use shall with I and shall be plus verb plus ing. Similarly, we see in all the other examples. We come down to perfect form. Let's consider present perfect tense, past perfect tense and future perfect tense. First example is of present perfect tense. I have written a letter. I had written a letter. I shall have written a letter. We see that the verb is in the third form. He has eaten an apple. He had eaten an apple. He will have eaten an apple. She has sung melodiously. She had sung melodiously. And she will have sung melodiously. They have walked. They had walked. And they will have walked. For any doubts, please refer to my second, third and fourth videos on tenses. Next is present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense and future perfect continuous tense. First example, I have been writing a letter. I had been writing a letter. I shall have been writing a letter. He has been eating an apple. He had been eating an apple. He will have been eating an apple. She has been singing melodiously. She had been singing melodiously. She will have been singing melodiously. They have been walking. They had been walking. They will have been walking. In this form, we see the usage of have been plus verb plus ing or had been or will have been or shall have been. With this, we finished the comparison in a jiffy. This was a very small video, and let's come down to the last part of the video, that is the word of the day. But today we have two, so it is the words of the day. So first word of the day is eccentric. What do you mean by eccentric? Means unconventional, freakish, or outlandish. Let's see some examples. The eccentric old man ate cat food. The old man was unconventional or freakish that he ate cat food. Rita has this eccentric habit of wearing her socks over her shoes. That is so unconventional, so outlandish. Second one is fabricate. Fabricate means construct, cook up, or invent. For example, don't try to fabricate a story for your unacceptable behavior. That means don't try to construct or cook up a false story. A new method to fabricate a spherical lens was proposed. That means a new method of inventing a spherical lens was proposed. With that, we come down to the end of this video. For any doubts, queries or suggestions, please mail me at learnwithmefromhome@gmail.com. Until we meet next, please stay safe, take care, and goodbye.